The story of Filipino-American labor leader Larry Itliong now being told as a musical. Let's take a look.
The story of famed Filipino-American labor leader Larry Itliong is told through song and dance in Larry the Musical. He's known to have organized and led protests in the 1930s for equal pay and dignified living conditions for farm and cannery workers throughout the West Coast and Alaska, up until the formation of the United Farm Workers in 1966. The musical is based on the book Journey for Justice, The Life of Larry Itliong, by the late Dr. Don Mabalon and by Gail Roman Santa, who is a writer and the executive producer of Larry the Musical.
What you see here are artists. What you're going to see is dance. You're going to see choreography. You're going to see singing. Filipinos love to sing. We have such amazingly talented singers. You're going to see script. You're going to see movement. And so that really, those tangible things that we can see ourselves and really feel the history, that we've never been able to just sit back and see the history in all of its joy, because our people are super funny and resilient.
Larry the Musical features a wide range of Phil-Am talent. Its actors say this is a unique experience to play a role that represents their culture.
I really feel that it is a privilege and honor to be part of something that is written by Filipino-Americans, specifically a female writing this material. When I'm acting on that stage, I feel like I've never played a part like this before. You know, I get to play myself. I get to play my mom, my titas, you know. It's rare.
I hope that it becomes a catalyst for more Filipino Americans to be on stage and shine and tell their own story and feel comfortable in a role that was actually written for them rather than a role that they're trying to fit into.
The cast and crew behind Larry the Musical hope that this performance will not only entertain but also educate the audience behind what some may say are the overlooked contributions of Phil-Ams in the historic fight for labor rights in the U.S.
I think when people walk out, I want for them to know that it's important to remember our history, to pass it down, you know, to future generations, because it doesn't end with us. It continues on.
I think if I want the audience to take away anything from the show, it's to fight for the things that you believe in. Especially after everything that Larry did, even though he was barely talked about, it was still such an important thing to do because he knew it was bigger than just himself.
Itliong was a fierce political union strategist, leading the Delano grape strike in the 1960s, teaming up with Cesar Chavez and Dolores Huerta and other Mexican farm workers. He passed away in 1977, and Larry the Musical is the latest example of keeping his legacy alive for future generations of Phil-Ams.
There's real story there about how conflicted they were and how conflicted Larry Itliong was. We're not trying to create a martyr here. We're trying to show you what happens to a leader within his community and how does he get out of what ultimately could be his downfall, which is the creation of the UFW, which is in a beautifully amazing moment for many leaders. These beautiful milestones and these moments also enter you into a realm of superstardom. And then sometimes it takes you down a dark way.
Larry the Musical runs from March 16th to April 14th at the Brava Theater in San Francisco. For more details, visit LarryTheMusical.com. Ramel Quinclera, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.
The latest adventure of Godzilla and Kong features familiar faces, new villains, and a pint-sized but feisty mini Kong. Our Hollywood correspondent Yong Chavez gives us a look.
Super-sized battle sequences are featured prominently in Godzilla Kong, The New Empire, the latest team-up between two of the most powerful titans. The iconic characters dominate the screen with their might as they face new challenges that threaten every living thing on Earth. Kaylee Huttle returns as Gia, Kong's human friend. The young deaf actress was first introduced in Godzilla vs. Kong.
I think when I watch the movies, we don't realize how much work is actually involved in it. But now that I've been making movies, there's a lot of time that it takes to make the movies. You know, doing things over and over again, that takes a lot of patience to make the movies. But when I watch movies, you don't think that it takes a lot of time, but I realize it actually takes a lot more time than you think it does.
How did you realize that the acting is something that you wanted to do?
I didn't know if I wanted to be an actor, but I thought I would go for this role. And then when I got the second movie, I thought that was so cool. So we, of course, it's been such a great experience, and I'm very honored to be acting in such a big movie like this. But for the rest of my life, I don't know what I want to do. I'll have to see what I want to do.
Like other films in the MonsterVerse, the film used computer-generated imagery, or CGI, as well as practical elements to come up with the eye-popping battle scenes and lifelike visuals. Godzilla Kong, The New Empire was filmed mostly in Australia. Rebecca Hall reprises her role as Dr. Eileen Andrews, Gia's adoptive mother, who is learning to adapt amidst the changes faced by her daughter.
I really had a very enjoyable time on the first movie, and I haven't had a lot of experience of sort of revisiting a world that I sort of played in before, and it's a really fun experience to come back to something, because there is an element of almost nostalgia, because you sort of remember the things that you enjoyed about the last one, but you also have opportunities to build on it.
Family is also a subject that's important for Kong, especially when he meets a mini version of himself, the film's new character named Zuko. The ensemble cast of Godzilla Kong, The New Empire also includes Brian Tyree Henry, Fala Chen, and Dan Stevens. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.